We're currently stuck between two forces. We've got the inflation environment, which is relatively benign. Inflation over the last 6 months, a year, has largely surprised to the downside. For example, the central bank was expecting inflation to peak at 6.4% in the second quarter. It actually peaked at 6.1% in the first quarter, and the decline in inflation subsequent to that has all been positive surprises. And this then coming back is of course very good for bonds because it means that it had downside surprises to or downside adjustments to the expected inflation component. Now that set an underlying bullish tone from a valuation point of view, which then got overlaid by a global environment where yields around the world are exceptionally low, not only in developed markets but in many emerging markets as well. And as international fund managers have been looking for yield, what they've been doing is they've been selling their US bonds, selling their UK bonds and European bonds, and buying South African bonds amongst others. It's not unique to South Africa. Countries like Mexico, Poland, Malaysia have all been enjoying benefits of this global diversification and search for yield. And all of these have contributed to what was a relatively bullish environment for bonds, with bond yields not reacting much to bad news, and in fact, generally bond yields have been declining, and therefore prices have been going up. However, over the last month or two, we've now been inundated by a rash of very bad news. And it started with the Marikana shootings, which have, of course, spiraled over into wide-scale unrest in the mining industry. And the consequence of this has been that our export sector has been quite negatively impacted, and we know that our current account data as a consequence is looking rather bad. For example, the most recent trade data was surprised meaningfully to the downside, coming out at $12 billion deficit instead of a $6 billion deficit for the month of August. Now this matters for the bond market, because if you're running a very big current account deficit, then the risk is that your currency can weaken. And as a consequence, if your currency weakens, it's of course bad for inflation, and that would push your bond yields up again. So after Marikana and all the bad news that we got in terms of the trade deficits, we were struck by the ratings downgrade by Moody's. And in some sense, the bad news from the rating agencies had preceded the mining sector in that we've been put on negative watch between November and January 9 months ago. And the Moody's downgrade was largely expected, because over that period, very few of the macro fundamentals had actually shown any form of improvement. Everything had deteriorated outside of the inflation outlook. If you looked at current account, if you looked at growth forecasts, most of these things had been declining. And so this ultimately triggered a Moody's downgrade. And the big concern there about the downgrade, while the downgrade itself, the timing was a little bit surprising, but the fact that they also left us on negative watch after having downgraded us was also quite a negative signal. And of course, now we're looking to Standard & Poor's and Fitch, and we're expecting them to downgrade us as well at some stage. And this doesn't help the bond market, because it means that your risk premium that sits in your yields has to go up, and hence the bond market would react negatively to this. More often than not, this is more particular to our international debt, our dollar, foreign currency denominated debt, but there are spillover effects onto the domestic bond market. And then on top of that, we're now facing the politics, ANC going into its elective conference in December, and of course, to some extent, the mining sector turbulence could contribute or could be partially because of the political struggle that's going on internal to the ANC. And then as we look ahead, we expect this to continue. We expect lots of political posturing to go. And as you have this increased political uncertainty, it again adds into the risk premium in bond yields. So at the moment, we're actually in quite a troubled patch for the bond market. And the question, you know, is should we expect bond yields to decline or rise through this type of period? And certainly, these bond yields are likely to go higher.